Let's go to our man on baseball, Mike Arsenault, semi-pro ball player in a past life. Mm-hmm. You were mentioning this on Twitter, and I think this is such a great point. The Jays were facing a rookie pitcher yesterday, right?
Second start ever in his career, first of the postseason, obviously, 24 years old, a soft-tossing lefty, and they couldn't score a run. That's 8 runs in only 5 games. They scored only 3 runs in the 4 losses. That's not going to cut it, because if the Los Angeles Dodgers make it to the World Series, if they can't hit an 85-mile-per-hour rookie, how are they going to do against Clayton Kershaw? The scary thing for Jays fans is really the game is down to 6 innings because of Andrew Miller in the back half of Cleveland's bullpen is just unstoppable, and it's due to the approach that the Jays are taking to the plate against Miller, who has a big fastball, that big sweeping slider. Instead of just trying to make contact, shortening their swing, they're still trying to hit home runs.
We got to get away from that.
That's what I mean. You got to play small ball. Cleveland's doing it. They're stealing bases. They're bunting. They're getting guys over. You can't live and die by the home run in postseason baseball.
What do we think he means by that? Does he mean that but does he feel that they don't want Canada in the World Series?
What he means is he wants the media to talk about the umpires, and that's the reason why the Jays aren't hitting. But Bautista has a reputation of being someone who does complain a lot about balls and strikes. I mean, I'm seeing a lot of borderline pitches that can go either way. Cleveland doesn't seem to be having that much of an issue. I mean, they're both not hitting well. Both teams aren't hitting well, but they're able to capitalize on the chances they do have. Really, the Jays' bats, they're big bats that are making all the money, need to step up today if we want to see a game 5.
Okay, so Bautista's taking a page out of Donald Trump's book then. Distraction. Let's throw something else out there.
A little misdirection,
maybe.
I think so,
yeah.
Yes.
Okay. The question moving forward now is, are we going to see Jose Bautista's attitude and his swagger next season for the Jays? His contract is up. So is Edwin's. Do you think we can afford them both?
You're going to make a qualifying offer to both, but in spring training, it was mentioned that Jose was looking for 5 years, $150 million. An injury-plagued, disappointing season. There's no way he's going to get that. I'd offer him 3 years, $15, $20 million per season. See what he thinks about that. Edwin.
Can I write that down?
Yes.
I'm going to send that to Givi.
Okay. Yeah. Edwin, I would like to see him come back. I'd rather have Edwin over than Jose. He's a little bit younger and I think more productive going forward. But I think you have to at least try to sign them or the fan base might revolt. Right. The Toronto Maple Leafs are back in action tonight at the United Center in Chicago. After 2 tough losses against the Winnipeg Jets and Minnesota Wild, the Leafs are looking to salvage a win in the finale of this 3-game road trip. While Toronto is no doubt playing an exciting brand of hockey to open the season, that excitement is not yet translating to success in the win-loss column. The Leafs enter the game with a 1-1-2 record. Auston Matthews is tied for the league lead in goals with 5. Toronto takes on a Chicago Blackhawks squad that is 2-3 on the year thus far. The source of Chicago's struggles has been the penalty kill. They've given up 11 power play goals in just 5 games.